If you're using TouchMix 30 firmware 2.0 or higher, you have the ability to integrate with third-party control surfaces. That's right, you can now use physical faders to control your TouchMix. When using external control surfaces, you'll have direct access to many of TouchMix's functionalities. You can also connect a control surface to an iPad that is connected to the mixer wirelessly, giving you a fully functional remote mixing setup anywhere in the venue. Let's take a look at how it works and how you set it up. Before moving on, make sure your TouchMix is using the latest software version. For instructions on updating your mixer's firmware, you can watch our firmware update video. My apologies, the presenters in that video aren't quite as dashing and handsome as I am, but the info is still good. There are a few different models of control surfaces that will work with TouchMix. A list of controllers we've verified can be found on our website. You can find the link to that in the video description. These controllers are primarily designed to control DAW software, and the features of each controller vary just a little bit. Because of this, some are a better match for TouchMix than other ones. For this video, we're going to be working with the Platform M Plus from Icon. We've also connected the optional D2 platform display accessory. This particular controller has features that match the TouchMix 30 Pro very well without a lot of additional functions that aren't required for the application. To control the mixer directly, connect the control surface to one of the USB-A ports of the TouchMix 30 Pro using a USB-A to USB-B cable. Once connected, the control surface will connect to the TouchMix and the faders will move into position. If the D2 display is also used, the channel names from the TouchMix will be displayed there as well. Once connected, the external control surface will operate primary channel functions, channel level via the faders and pan using the channel rotary knob controls, the mute button does what you'd expect it to, and the solo button does the same thing as the TouchMix Q button. There's even a record button that arms the channel for multi-track recording. The ninth fader will control the level for the selected mix. Note that the labels on this channel's buttons differ from those on the input channels, but they do the same thing. There's even a jog wheel that duplicates the TouchMix master encoder function. Up above that, there are full recording transport controls available as well. And up here, we have channel and bank navigation buttons that make it easy to quickly navigate through the various fader banks and mixes. Or you can navigate from the mixer screen, and the control surface will follow. You might have also noticed that the fader view looks a little bit different now. More on that in a second. Last, the select button will take you into a channel to work with EQ, dynamics, sends, and presets. With an external controller connected to the mixer, it is no longer necessary to display the graphic faders on the mixer screen. We have access to all of that right on the controller. The version 2.0 firmware update offers a companion screen mode that can be used while controlling the mixer externally. To display the channel strip view, go to Menu, and press External Faders. The External Fader screen mode is also activated on the first press of any of the Select or Navigation buttons on the controller itself. The channel strip view replaces the faders on screen with an overview of the channels that shows the EQ, gate, and compressor activity, level meters, and more. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, you can also connect the external controller to an iPad and control the TouchMix remotely. There are a few different ways to do this, and you will need a couple of cables and adapters to make it work, but don't worry, I'll tell you everything you need to know. Before you start, make sure your tablet has the latest version of the TouchMix Control app installed. The first approach is to connect your iPad to the mixer using Wi-Fi, just as you've probably already been doing. If you need more information on this, you can check out our video on how to connect TouchMix to a router. Next, you're going to connect the control surface to the iPad. The simplest way to do this is to use a USB-B to lightning cable, sometimes also called a lightning to MIDI cable, to connect the control surface to your iPad. Connect the external controller to the iPad through the lightning port using the USB-B to lightning cable. Now connect your TouchMix 30 Pro using Wi-Fi and launch the TouchMix Control app. You now have full remote control of the mixer with the external controller. There's another method that will let you keep your iPad charged during the show. Connect the external controller to the iPad using an Apple Lightning to USB 3 camera adapter. Connect the external controller to the USB port on the camera adapter. Now, connect the camera adapter to the iPad and connect the charger to the Lightning port on the adapter. This method is ideal for keeping power supplied to the iPad during longer events. The third method is to make a wired connection to the router from the mixer, the iPad, and the external controller. This method is great for ensuring that you have a strong connection maintained between the mixer and the iPad and the external controller. For this method, we're going to need a slightly different adapter. Specifically, one that has an RJ45 or Ethernet port along with the Lightning and USB inputs. Begin by connecting the iPad to the same router that the TouchMix is connected to using the adapter and an RJ45 cable. Next, connect the control surface to the adapter using a USB A to USB B cable. You can also connect a charger to the adapter to keep the iPad battery topped off. In any of the three methods, once connected, the external control surface will connect to the TouchMix and the faders will move into position. If the D2 display is also used, the channel names from the TouchMix will be displayed just like connecting it to the mixer directly. Setting up an external controller with a TouchMix 30 Pro mixer can be advantageous for multiple scenarios. For instance, the mixer can live close to the performers as a stage box and can receive all of the input connections. With remote access to the mixer from an iPad and a connected external controller, the mix engineer has the ability to choose where in the venue they want to set up their front of house position with nothing but a network connection. The app provides an exact copy of the UI on the TouchMix and allows you to control the mixer completely from your tablet. The only control that isn't available from the tablet is the analog trim knob. But TouchMix has plus and minus 15 dB of digital gain on every input that is controllable from the tablet. The trim knobs on the mixer can be set to a nominal value. Noon or 1 o'clock should suffice for most input sources. The digital gain can then be adjusted to set and fine-tune the gain stage for each input. Access to this control is maintained throughout the performance from the tablet. And, with the controller connected, you can easily adjust this another way by pressing down on the pan knob for any given input. On top of that, the mixer is still active. The workstation is now doubled. If two engineers are operating the event, one engineer can be on stage mixing monitors on the TouchMix itself, while the front of house engineer can be set up remotely with an iPad and an external control surface. Connecting an external control surface provides extended flexibility with your TouchMix. Thanks for watching this video. We'll see you next time.